What's going on, guys, and welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to be getting into some groundbreaking technology in the hemp industry. I'm super excited to bring you guys this content today, so without any further ado, let us go ahead and dive right on in to the content. Yes, sir, you already know. Like, subscribe, hit that bell button notification, and don't forget to get down in that Discord. You can find that in the pinned comment as well as the video description, extra lit down there. It will definitely help you out. I guarantee if you don't know anything about it, trust me, I had somebody reach out to me on a Facebook group and be like, let's be honest, is the Discord really worth it? And I almost didn't even reply back to them because it's like, bro, it's 10 bucks a month and it will help you better your future. I guarantee if you do not get your money's worth, then you just get a refund. But you will, and probably lots more. So go check that out in the pinned comment right there. So I'm Grim from WKU Consulting. You already know how we do. We keep you on the cutting edge of all things in the hemp industry. We are going to talk about the cutting edge tech of hemp batteries. Bam, let's get right into it here. So number one, I want to talk about BIMP. And if you take battery and hemp and add them together, you get BIMP. Now, BIMP is a Texas-based startup, BIMP Research Corporation, which has developed a lithium-ion battery alternative. Thank God for that. Finally, a lithium-ion battery alternative. BIMP is courting investors to raise capital to develop and commercialize its B4C hemp, short for boron carbide made from hemp, lithium sulfur battery technology. And this battery will do everything that its predecessors cannot do. Successful implementation that has been engineered and independently tested at the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee, UWM. Prototypes of BIMP's LIS B4C hemp technology offer significant advantages over lithium-ion batteries. The company asserts that commercial applications of LIS B4C hemp would overcome lithium-ion battery challenges in terms of cost, weight, scalability, performance, and recyclability. All of the things that everything that is wrong with the battery industry right now can be, not surprisingly, replaced by hemp. So let's talk about some of the things that a hemp battery will do. Why is this a better solution? Well, for number one, batteries can be fully charged in 20 minutes. That's right. You can have a large set scale battery fully charged at full capacity in 20 minutes. 20 minutes. Fully charged. Imagine plugging that in to your car. It is good for about 100,000 miles when fast charging is used in that 20-minute time frame that we were just talking about. Now, I know everybody is la 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 la. Well, Tesla just made a million-mile battery. Yes, correct, but it is also incredibly expensive to produce due to the graphene in its nature. And also, it is an incredible pollutant. So 100,000 miles, and don't worry, the technology will advance as the technology advances. That might sound a little bit redundant to you, but it does make sense to me. 100,000 miles per battery in one of these cars. So not only could you fully charge your car in about 20 minutes, but that battery will last for about 100,000 miles before the battery is just discharged. What really makes this great is that batteries will not combust, nor will they leak harmful materials into the environment when they are recycled. So they are much safer. Hemp batteries are much safer than normal lithium-ion batteries. They store an incredible amount of energy and discharge an incredible amount of energy very, very quickly. They can discharge all of the stored energy in a matter of milliseconds if, in fact, the power requirement dictates that that should be so. The great thing is that when these things get hot or get close to that, when the battery goes bad, these are not going to spontaneously combust like we know a couple of Porsches out there have done. Batteries will not combust. Also, when they are recycled, they will not leak harmful materials into the environment. The only valuable material inside of that battery still is just the lithium in the lithium sulfur battery. So to replenish that lithium or recollect that lithium is a walk in the park when it compared to alternatives on how a battery is manufactured and discarded in today's day and age. Number four, it will be ready for commercial production in 2026, right in line with about the time that probably everybody in America at least will be required to be driving electric vehicles. I do not want to drive an electric vehicle with the current energy crisis, because I know that production of more electric vehicles, while yes, may cut down on greenhouse carbon emissions as it exists in the tailpipe, but as it exists in the manufacturing plant, it is not a sustainable energy outcome, and plus those batteries pollute everything. Not to mention, they're pretty dangerous. Go look up fires from EV vehicles. A hemp battery is going to replace all of that. And I'm going to get into how is it made. There's also another video that's coming right here in just a second. How is it made? Well, the fibrous material of the hemp stalk, and I love this because it's the bast. The bast is what is mostly thrown away in agriculture in large-scale hemp production. Most of the time, the farmers are just throwing it away. So literally, you can make a superior battery with waste. That's right, with waste. The fibrous material of the hemp stalk is cooked, quote unquote, and then processed into carbon nano sheets. They use this to make supercapacitors. It's 8 times stronger as far as a discharge rate than lithium ion, and it is at 1/1000th of the cost to produce. So that means that the manufacturer's cost will be decreased, and then therefore that cost passed on to consumers will be maybe not 1/1000th of the cost, because they're still going to get their money and all the technology and R&D and everything that went into it, but that cost is still going to be significantly reduced for us as a consumer, and that's amazing. Here is some photographic image of the hemp bast fiber before. A, that's what those fibrous materials look like when harvested basically as a waste product in large-scale agricultural hemp production, and then after hydrothermal carbonization. And if you're wondering what I'm talking about, check this out right here.
With the advancement of technology, it has been proven that hemp can be used to make several things. Not just anything, but better things. Like better clothing, better components of our gadgets, and even better foods. And now, research has proven that from hemp, you can extract graphene and diamonds in the form of nanosheets, which are used to make supercapacitors. And it is being said that these are stronger and better than those made from regular graphene, which is already seen as the industry gold standard. How come? What parts of this plant are used? How did they get here? How does it work? What benefit does it bring to the battery industry? These questions and many more will be answered in the course of this video. Before we go into the details of hemp batteries and the graphene and diamonds made from hemp fibers, let's quickly look at the process of making hemp batteries. The hemp plant woody pulp gotten from the hemp fiber is cooked and processed into carbon nanosheets. These nanosheets are used to design and develop tiny devices called supercapacitors. Supercapacitors are used as strong energy storage systems, typically of what a battery would do. With the current level of development of electronic components, there is a need for the development of better battery or energy storage systems that can store large amounts of energy and release them when needed. So, you may be wondering, how are diamonds and graphene made from hemp fibers? Well, large amounts of hemp bast are subjected to a certain degree of heat. It causes the release of several compounds in different states of matter, solid, liquid, and gas. While the gases are synthetic gases, the liquids are heavy oils, and the two can be used for different purposes. The solid is, however, biochar, a commercial waste product that is quickly gaining recognition as a soil additive for reintroducing carbon back into the soil. The most important components of biochar are graphene and industrial diamonds. However, these two are extracted from the biochar by the use of a pulsed plasma reactor. This process gives rise to biography and industrial diamonds. As already stated, hemp batteries are known as supercapacitors. That is to say, as capacitors, they can store very heavy and large charges. That is brilliant, isn't it? Of course, but how do hemp batteries work? Have you ever wondered how battery-powered electric cars work? If you know that, then you'd have an idea of how hemp batteries work. If you don't, then it is simple to grasp. Battery-powered electric vehicles need steady amounts of power while driving, and when they encounter a stoplight or have a need to use their brakes, they will also need a burst of electrical energy to start going again after that stop. This kind of energy is not seen in lithium-ion batteries, which happen to be the most common type of battery in the battery industry. Lithium-ion batteries can store large amounts of energy for some time, and use them slowly. Hemp batteries made from hemp fibers, or supercapacitors on the other hand, can discharge all their load of electrical energy as fast as possible to give the electric vehicle the boost it needs. The only problem is hemp batteries do not hold their charge for a long time. But with the introduction of regenerative energy obtained from braking, they can absorb more charges. Pretty amazing, right? You know what hemp batteries are and how they work. Do you wonder why hemp batteries? What qualities do they have that make them the most preferable to other kinds of batteries in the battery industry? The most important reason is the sustainability of hemp batteries. On the planet today, everyone craves a sustainable source of energy as well as a sustainable method of storing energy. Did you know that hemp batteries replacing lithium-ion batteries will help with attaining the sustainability everyone craves? Hemp batteries are made from hemp plants, which are readily available and not as expensive as lithium-ion batteries. This makes them sustainable. One reason for the sustainability of hemp batteries is that hemp plants are cheap to produce. They do not need pesticides or fertilizers and can grow rapidly in any environment they find themselves in. This makes it possible to achieve sustainable energy and also a greener planet with clean, inexpensive, and abundant energy. Hemp batteries are made from the hemp bast, a part of the hemp plant that is usually thrown away during the production of industrial hemp. That is to say, hemp batteries are made from waste products from industrial hemp production. The bast is a nanocomposite that is composed of layers of crystalline cellulose, hemicellulosis, and lignin. When correctly processed, the bast of the hemp plant separates into graphene-like sheets or nanosheets, which mostly have dimensions of up to 2 to 5 nanometers. Researchers from the University of Alberta believe that the supercapacitor made from hemp has a maximum energy density of about 49 kilowatts per kilogram, which is higher than most commercial electrodes that have 17 kilowatts per kilogram and are obtained from activated carbon. The hemp fibers are not only used for making graphene-like sheets that act as powerful hemp batteries, they are also used for making oil, clothing, and ropes. They are also very sustainable and are cheap to produce. They do not need pesticides or fertilizers, and they grow rapidly. Now we have seen what hemp batteries are, how they are made, and how they work. Let's quickly look at their benefits. Graphene is a common material that is used in most silicon chips, solar cells, and most importantly, batteries. But graphene has one big disadvantage. It is very difficult to make in large quantities, however. Graphene-like sheets made from hemp fibers are better than regular graphene. Why? Hemp is readily available. They can be cultivated in any soil and any climate. They are also quick to mature and can develop into mature plants without stress, fertilizers, or within a few months of cultivation. This makes them a better choice for batteries. One of the benefits of substituting regular batteries for hemp batteries is the cost of production. Hemp batteries are very cheap. They are so cheap that they are made from waste from hemp plants that hemp farmers do not need. This makes hemp batteries easier to make and cheaper than graphene or other kinds of batteries. In the not so distant future, the world will need lots of batteries to power their vehicles, cities, and even homes. And for that, they will need cheaper batteries like hemp batteries. One of the benefits of hemp batteries over regular batteries is because of their high level of energy density. When it comes to batteries, energy density is important. It is the amount of electrical energy a battery source can hold in relation to its actual weight. When the energy density of a battery is higher than another, it means the battery with the high energy density is stronger than the other hand from researchers. Hemp batteries have a higher energy density compared to lithium-ion batteries. This means they are better and stronger than lithium-ion batteries. A good battery can maintain and sustain its ability at any given temperature. Hemp batteries are good examples of good batteries. Their conductivity is the same whether in cold climates or hot temperatures. They have very strong temperature resistance. This is one of the most impressive benefits of hemp batteries over lithium-ion batteries. Imagine having a battery that can be used in the iciness of winter weather and the heat of summer without any troubles at all. What makes a good battery is its ability to conduct electricity with the smallest form of resistance. This is superconductivity. When a material is very resistant to electricity, it is less conductive and hence less efficient as a form of battery. These types of materials are not good for batteries because they do not do the primary work of the battery. which is to conduct electricity. Hemp fibers, on the other hand, are different. Hemp batteries from hemp fibers are superconductors of electricity. They have a very high level of conductivity, probably because of the graphene and diamond-like sheets made from their fibers that are used as electrodes in hemp batteries. But with all of these, hemp batteries have their fair share of shortcomings. It's not all rosy for it. Many researchers are quick to acknowledge the many benefits of hemp batteries, but there are a lot of limitations they fail to see or purposely overlook. Supercapacitors made from hemp fibers are indeed good for storing energy and can be used across several applications. They are, in fact, not normal batteries. Hemp batteries, as previously stated, cannot store electrical energy as long as a lithium-ion battery would, even though they can store more charges than lithium-ion batteries. However, the energy stored in hemp batteries can be harnessed more quickly than those in lithium-ion batteries, making it a good choice for users who want a quick burst of energy. Another limitation is in the aspect of development. Hemp batteries still need a lot of development before they can favorably compete with lithium-ion batteries. These developments, we believe, will come in the future. However, research has proven that hemp batteries would be one of the world's best attempts at attaining sustainable and clean energy. What do you think about hemp batteries as energy storage systems? Do you think they will soon be the world's go-to system for energy storage, or the world's best attempt at a sustainable future?
Yes, yes, yes. And if you don't, let us know in the comment. Of course you can. Well, let me ask you some questions. If, yes, and if you think that we can actually make a good attempt, if you haven't watched my video on sustainable energy and what hemp can do, watch the video popping up above right there. But if hemp can be used to reduce and eliminate toxins in the ground, provide a better alternative medicine, provide a stronger than steel textile, replace paper products, make better insulation, make stronger, more resistant concrete, create a superior energy storage alternative, initiate more carbon sequestration than trees, which means better air quality, less global warming, and provide a better vegan nutritional source, all while enabling us to fight cancer and pain with CBD oil in the flowers, Why is this not only legal by the farm bill, but should be mandatory? Hemp will do so much, guys. It is a wonderful thing to be part of the industry. And I know everybody out there working on the laboratory, but I'm telling you, this singular hemp plant not only has the ability to produce a better, more holistic medicine, but can probably change and revolutionize our life as humans on this planet for many, many years to come, and maybe pass down a better inhabitable planet for ourselves and our posterity. I'm Grim. It has been a blessing, a privilege, nay, an honor to be able to teach and consult with you guys today, and I'll see you in the next video.